Hi. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Jerome. I am French, and I have been a snowboard photographer for the past 10 years. 3 years ago, I started to film everything with a tiny video cam fixed on top of my photo cameras.
Do you still have your third nipple?
And I mean everything.
I'm so pissed, man. I can't take a shit.
Every jump, every line, every single try on every single spot. Everything I took a picture of, and more. And as I followed these so-called professional snowboarders, who would literally fly to the other side of the world to spend days to build a jump and slam 50 times in a row, I started asking myself some serious questions. What the fuck are we doing here? I mean, what's the point of all this shit?
Dude, I'm just filming the real life. Not
your hands down your pants. You're touching yourself. You're pulling your shirt off, dude. Come on. Who's fucking French now, huh? You fucking weirdo.
Snowboarding does look awesome when you cut out all the lame stuff, but what about taking a good long stare at ground level reality? You see, there's one thing I really need to know. Among all this block stacking, beer drinking, weed smoking, gas burning, energy drink sponsoring, is there or is there not anything truly beautiful? And so, by browsing hundreds of hours of the shittiest footage, we will find out if we, snowboarders, really are true heroes of our time, modern-day icons of epicness and freedom, or if we're just a bunch of spoiled, intentionally cool, self-centered sellouts.
Yo, dude!
We will travel back and forth to Austria, France, Alaska, Japan, Canada, Switzerland, India, Italy, and Sweden to build the exact same jump you've already seen 100 times. Fly, build, land, post, party. Repeat. But as we sleep in sketchy igloos, shit our pants in Alaska, lose ourselves to sake, escape death by avalanche, move around cubic meters of snow, slam our bones onto the ground again, again, and again, we are going to see what it takes to make a video part.
How about that? The finding the mile, man.
Was that it?
He might have even been a little too front board on the, like, almost blunt.
Meet some of the most passionate snowboarders. I mean, look at these guys.
Do I have boogers in my nose?
We're gonna play Uno with our Olympic gold medalist.
I was trying to correct myself.
But most importantly, we will explain precisely why shots like this one are so incredibly awesome. Genuine masterpieces of mankind's creations. It is going to be shaky. It is going to be raw.
Celui-là, il était pour toi.
But it's going to be the truth. And from the truth shall emerge the eternal beauty of snowboarding. The average pro snowboarder is in his 20s. He deliberately looks like shit, smokes tons of weed, and has only one obsession, snowboarding. If he's not riding, he's watching videos. Videos for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Difficult to backside channel cap double or switchback rodeo?
Switchback rodeo.
I think it's a good spot for switchback rodeo.
Yeah, basic.
Daydreaming about tricks takes the rest of his free time, along with checking his Instagram.
I'm just not into the brown hair girls, but oh.
Being popular on social media is crucial, so he will always wait for somebody to be filming to post it later.
Qu'est-ce que tu fais, Bourbouz?
Je check un spot là.
Vas-y, casse him.
When posting, he makes sure to tag his sponsors because that's in his contracts. You may ask, why then does he deliberately look like shit? Simple. He's too cool to dress up. Therefore, looking extremely random is the most trendy thing. To achieve this, he makes a precise use of old sweaters from grandma, fisherman's hats, ugly face masks, or even better, the neck warmer on top of the beanie. If he has a more classic style, he will always flatten his outfit before dropping in.
Alright, you guys good?
We good.
On a down day, he will get high and watch more videos. At night, he drinks beers, tries to hook up with 18-year-old chicks, and plays Uno.
One second, guys.
His life peaks when sitting behind the car, he rolls a big one and dreams about tricks he'll never land.
Imagine it.
Switch method?
Mm.
Switch front one would be cool.
Cowboy insert.
Switch front three would be fucking insane.
Switch method would be better.
If ever he actually lands one, he uses a wide range of adjectives to describe it.
Sick.
Sick.
That was 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 fucking sick.
That was so sick.
So sick.
So sick.
So sick.
So sick.
So sick.
So fucking sick.
That's pretty sick.
It's pretty sick.
Pretty sick, man.
Sick, man. Sick, man.
Sick, man.
Boom!
Sick.
The main goal of his winter is to have someone follow him around to film him. His best tricks are edited together in the next big videos with a selected song and becomes his video part. He goes around the world to slide on the same rail, jump the same pillow. He rebuilds the very same jump as the year before because it's the best way to stack footage.
Oh!
He spends 6 months on the road for this 3 minutes clip because he actually falls most of the time.
Oh, fuck!
Oh, shit.
If he still fails after dozens and dozens of tries, he will whine or get mad.
For fuck's sake, man! Fuck! 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 Fuck, man! Fuck! 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 Fuck me! Fuck!
Motherfucker!
Fuck!
Guitar!
Stop it, man! Fuck!
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 To make a living, He finds sponsors within the industry, he sticks their logos on his boards, he attends a catalog shoot once a year and posts as many pictures of himself as possible. But the biggest contracts are found with energy drink companies.
How do you think, dude?
They buy every cool rider to sell their addicting shit products to kids who don't need it. But that's none of his problem, because man, he needs cash to make his video part. And if he does not take their money, someone else will. If he is talented enough and sells out real good, he will be able to accomplish the dream of every pro snowboarder, buy an Audi and a house on the coast. So what does he do in the summer then? You guessed it, he surfs. While you struggle to make a living, while the great challenges of mankind are being battled by everyday men and women, this selfish motherfucker flies to some paradise island to surf and play more fucking Uno. Yes, and he does not understand why anyone would want to work in an office, let alone a factory. Factories where, in the third world, the clothings he promotes are made. What about photographers like myself? Well, we are exactly the same. Except, we suck too much at snowboarding, so we picked up a camera to stay around. We are snowboarders, we are living the dream, and we don't give a shit what you think.
Are you guys ready? Do I grab or no grab?
Best day ever.
How was your backside 180? Did you have fun?
Yeah, you could pop more.
Fuck, my knees, dude.
You haven't seen my video part.
Just a bit further and I would have nailed it.
What is the most aerodynamic grab?
Yeah, it's corked, man. That's fucking dope, man.
Does it matter if we see the tracks or should we try to get fresh stuff?
Should I do a backside 7?
No internet in here.
Should we go?
All my stuff are wet.
Oh, my boots are so wet.
Ah! All my goggles are fucked.
Switch is gonna be hard, huh?
Whoa! Are we in Japan?
Dude,
have you seen that photo?
Fucking kidding me.
It's insane.
Cover time.
This is 3-day build.
Did you get a shot?
Didn't get any shots for the last 2 weeks.
Fuck, I would like had the feeling that could land it and like...
Skaters would do it, dude. So sick, look at those snowflakes.
Maybe one more check.
Yeah, one more.
Looks decent.
Yeah.
Hey, it's better than nothing.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah, totally, dude.
Oui, défonce pas, man.
Alright. Tell me if I have to go more down.
I'm gonna be right above you, okay?
Yeah. Am I good here?
You're perfect, thank you.
Okay.
Fuck, no! Ow! Ow! Fuck off, man, you fucking little shit! Oh my god, you fucking retard.
Huh?
Oh, he's fucking filming every butt. No, just the guy turns on something.
What, you know?
Camera on my fucking face.
Fucking camera, dude.
Oh, oh my god. It's in your mouth.
Man, kajunga, man. Fuck.
Get. Drive.
Here we see a prime example of a snowboarder with withdrawals from internet. It's been 3 days since his last internet experience, and he's starting to feel the pressure. Will he be able to communicate with the outside world or not? Stay tuned, find out on our next episode of Snowboarders with Problems.
Filming.
Tell me, why am I wasting my life with you, Janne?
Wasting is making a lot of money. You never know, like might sell like 1 year, I might be famous one day, then you look, then you will be rich.
Eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 21 photos.
That's ridiculous. Did she just go down the line or was it sporadic?
They're kind of all over the place.
Was it thoughtful?
This girl?
Yeah.
What? Whoa, oh, she's got some
side tat. It's pretty sick.
Wow. You gotta find out where she is and go, Austin.
Not bad for a one night stand.
He's gonna score a world though.
Oh!
Yo! Oh, that's a good score.
Yeah.
He's going for it.
Oh my god.
Cap.
Triple!
Yeah! Oh,
what else?
Fuck!
Front side, double. Triple?
No, double.
Oh my god!
And back triple! Back trips. And back, it's trips. Done.
Back trips. Back trips.
Alright, now let me tell you a bit more about just a few of these guys. This is Janne. Janne is from Mikkeli, Finland. He has the most incredible facial expressions. And he never stops asking stupid questions.
Was I too far? Is it less poppy now?
Victor Davier is from Gap, France. He doesn't smoke, he cooks and dresses well. He's your perfect bachelor.
On s'est arrêté dans les champs. Flûte de pan. Et à cet endroit-là. Bon, vas-y.
Here you have Jason from Whitefish, Montana. He charges the steepest faces in the world, but still, he's a very shy and humble guy.
Jason, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Gigi comes from Au, Austria. He has been making groundbreaking video parts for the last 15 years and remains an eternal 12-year-old kid. His jokes being always two steps ahead, no one ever gets them.
Come, come.
You ever heard of Denver, the last dinosaur?
I only heard about Denver's fatal anal attraction. Which we don't want to talk about.
Then there is Louis from Quebec City. He always buttons up his black shirt to the very top. He doesn't speak much, but when he rides, he's got class. Victor Delerue comes from Saint-Lary, France.
Qu'est-ce que j'ai pas trouvé dans son petit sac?
His brain being completely empty, he knows absolutely no shame whatsoever. And like the others, he's a pure genius on a board. Now, take Grego. Grego is from Argentina. He's a passionate snowboard cameraman. he follows the winter on both hemispheres to film his friends.
I can spend 1 month without my girlfriend, but not without my Milanesa.
This is a guy who has not seen the face of summer for the past 12 years. Why would anyone do such a thing? Like Theo, Sam, Flo, Vlad, Shane, Butters, Hayden, and many others, he dedicates his life to film snowboarders. While the guys are having fun, they are the ones hiking with drones and steadicams, shoveling, fighting against storms, freezing toes and fingers, standing in the same spot all day to maybe capture one trick. Why? Definitely not for a good pay. No, because like every other snowboarder, they fell in love with it by watching magazines and videos when they were kids. Video parts, watched over and over again every day after school, which called them to escape from the standard path of society to follow their passion. So, obviously, they must find some sort of beauty in snowboarding. Justin here has made around 22 snowboard films. He's now 47, and instead of using his reputation to shoot commercials, he starts again every year with a new movie and hangs out with 20-year-old kids. Let's have a look at some of their footage now, shall we? While we are walking the streets, Luif is flying. Maybe he's just going to his work. That's the idea. But here, moving around the streets becomes art. He slides on this rail, blinded, jumps on the other one with ease, and keeps going like nothing fucking happened. Jason here drops impossible lines like you drink coffee. He turns a dangerous mountain into a playground, a face into a canvas. And Victor Davier here, coming in full speed, pops, starts grabbing as the kicker is falling apart, pushing style with every cell of his body, from his toes to his bended wrist, not moving an inch now that he has reached perfection. Masterpiece. Isn't that shit worth capturing? Isn't that worth all the struggle? All the shoveling until you fall asleep? To eventually get kicked out? The broken sleds, the building jumps until nightfall, the money spent on heli time, the pollution, the selling out.
Dude.
Actually, most of them embrace the anti-energy drinks movement called Drink Water, started by snowboarders to show the kids that they don't have to drink Red Bulls and such to be cool. And the reason they freak out when they can't land a trick is because they push themselves beyond the limits, scared to get hurt, adding stress to adrenaline, and because they want to land it so hard that they will always go back again, completely exhausted, and keep eating shit because they carry the hope that this time, yeah, this time, maybe he'll get it.
Yeah!
Not only get it, because if his arms moved even just a bit, he will go again.
Yeah.
Ouais, je veux checker, voir si j'ai bougé les bras.
Some like Frank carry a trick list to precisely build up their video parts like a work of art.
Ouais, j'ai racheté un beer gap to tap tantôt.
In his life, he broke around 40 boards and 20 bones. A bit too short? Here, Janne, have a broken nose and cheekbone. Avalanches are always on our mind, all the time. They are the one thing that we actually take seriously.
So, of course, if anything would pop, you know, you've got a high ground that you can get to.
Yeah! Fuck yeah, man.
Indeed, many pros have lost their lives to the mountain, like Jason's own brother, for instance, who keeps riding to his memory. Only he promised his mom to put on a helmet. Yusaku here carries the name of his best friend who recently died on a jump. Yeah, why not put on a fucking helmet, by the way? Because then it would look like a sport. To a certain extent, they are willing to put their lives on the line just for the beauty of it.
Oh no, he's moving, he's moving. Oh, he's okay!
Snowboarding is all about the looks because style is all that matters. What kind of balls do you need to jump gaps like these, blind until you're mid-air?
Oh my god!
To fly down faces like Victor Delerue here, death rides that look even twice more scary from the top. And seriously, how can a guy like him be such a snowboard master and yet so genuinely stupid?
We should shoot.
Keep the ball on.
Well, that is because they kept a child's heart. And so yeah, they don't give a shit what you think. And they will keep riding every single day, sometimes alone, shredding their home resort like Gigi here, jumping around the slopes everywhere they can, mixing it up with surfing and skateboarding.
Wow!
The one thing that all these guys have in common is an insatiable taste for freedom. And in their endless search for style, they have become brothers, my brothers. Each with a very unique and astounding personality, often hilarious and extremely lovable.
Best ever to breakfast.
I mean, come on, you gotta love these dudes.
Loser Vuno had to drink 80 proof rum, double.
I am so drunk. I had like 6 fucking drinks.
Their writing is their testament. Their video parts are their gift to the world. And therefore, their beautiful work has to be recorded and saved forevermore.
No, yeah, that's what it is.
Drop it five. Drop.
Shit!
Look at this blue
lover! He's freaking!
He's tripping because he has a yellow and he's never been so close! That's why!
Here we go.
Careful! Be careful! Wow, that was dramatic.
That was
insane.
That
was so dramatic.
Oh, Jérôme! Oh, putain, je me suis fait flageller par une branche! T'es trop fort! Un sapin m'a flagellé le visage! Vas-y, mets-moi des watts! Je prends des watts, Jérôme!
Deuxième barrel, sixième barrel,
barrel, vas-y, tiens. Oh Dieu, j'ai plus à respirer. Oh Dieu. Allez, vas-y, deep. Vas-y, deeper. Ok, sérieusement, Arto 7-Eleven.
Wake from your sleep.
Cocoa Krispies, so good.
Your tea. Désolé, les gars, j'ai un peu dégueulasse.
I was like 100% sure that was not going to work.
So what now? What did we achieve in these 3 years? Where's all that beauty? Man, I was looking for it. I got hung from a heli. I explored so many mountains. I took shits by minus 30. I traveled through a million landscapes. Thanks to Uno, I had to ride a slow blinded. And jump into a frozen lake. I sledded until my arms were numb. I got drunk, plenty.
Je suis complètement sous.
We had three people in the car. Oh, there's the fourth. Dude, I can't see.
I heard the song of the wind on all continents, as well as awful karaoke. I saw horses, monkeys, and even a fucking camel.
Oh, that's it. That's a camel. That's a camel.
I told you, there's a fucking camel.
That's insane.
I learned about different people and cultures. I heard the funniest sex stories.
She come in me with no condom.
Period, America.
Like straight on my dick with no condom. I was like, oh, what? Fuck.
As well as love stories.
Ah, je l'ai dit dans le pur, c'est des petits bisous, on se regardait, on croit dans les yeux. Ah, qu'est-ce que je fais, je dis pas. Mais c'est sorti tout seul, hein, j'ai fait. Ah, je t'aime.
T'as eu des petits frissons.
Ah, j'ai eu des petits frissons, mec, j'ai eu une susu.
Peeing could jump that pillow. And then the Hurley Gap. Found hot springs in the middle of nowhere. Saw every single winch break down, witnessed legendary tricks happen, found out that all stereotypes about Americans were true.
This might be the best day of my life.
Taking a little break.
Wow, these are really good.
Those, huh?
No, those are gross.
I got my ass kicked.
Ah! Oh, you crazy French guys.
And finally, I have seen a guy break his board and his ass.
Oh, oh, that's good. Ow. Oh, dude, ass.
To stand up, go again, only to break his ass a second time.
Oh no. Oh no.
And still take it with a smile.
So how was your day? Oh, I was sick, I got butt fucked and broke two boards. Good day.
Wait. Then there are the photos that we made together. I tried to capture a bit of that beauty I have been pointing at. Because we, snowboard photographers, believe that snowboarding can be truly beautiful. That these single-minded pot smokers are, indeed, artists. Are we inspiring people to live a more passionate and adventurous life? Maybe. Maybe not. But we spend our lives taking these photos, hoping that one day they will be hung up in a museum under the caption, "Rad dudes doing sick stuff." And that is the very reason why I shot them on film instead of digital. Because I wanted them to be more timeless, to stand the test of time. I tried to frame them like paintings, with a lot of grainy black and white for the drawing-like style. But still, while the world is struggling for peace, human rights and saving our planet, we're up here jumping in the snow, thinking that we're the coolest thing around. Where's the beauty in that? Well, aren't we using that very freedom our ancestors fought for? Shouldn't we be a little more grateful though? Surely, yeah. Thank you. Now let me ask, what is the point of having freedom if you don't use it to do what you love most? And I will finish on a quote from Walter Bonatti's first mountaineering book. But then, thinking about the age in which we live, where technology has brought triumphs under the North Pole and on the Moon, but also fat and softness to many men, victims of too much comfort, I said to myself, after all, what is more beautiful today than still being able to run barefoot and do somersaults in the fields?
Thank you. There we go.
Yeah.